Miniature artists usually tend to go even smaller than that, like a 1 is to 24 or 1 is to 48. I would have, since I was building an entire dollhouse, it would have been more logistically convenient to go with a smaller scale because this is pretty massive to like navigate in terms of like taking it anywhere for an exhibition and things like that. It is quite a difficult thing to maneuver. But at the same time, I couldn't really go smaller because, like I was saying, my doll had to be 1 is to 12 because to get a poseable doll smaller than that, a good quality poseable doll, is very difficult to get it any smaller than 1 is to 12 because it's a storytelling project. So the doll has to be able to do several different things. I have to be able to stage her in different scenes, and so I needed that flexibility in terms of scale, and that's why I ended up going with 1 is to 12 for the entire project. I do seasons with about, say, 9 to 12 episodes per season, and so producing each episode, it usually takes about a day per episode to kind of put together, to get to, I mean, planning and writing it happens beforehand, writing out the episode and figuring out what are the scenes I need, and kind of planning that in advance. But then actually producing the episodes, staging the various scenes, photographing them from all of the various angles needed, and then kind of processing them digitally, figuring out, okay, how am I presenting this in like a comic style, where am I adding text, if am I adding some animation to it and things like that, and figuring out all of the digital post-production later. So all in all, I would say roughly one episode takes a day to fully properly produce, or maybe 1 or 2 days to properly produce. So when I was growing up, I never particularly had a doll's house, nor did I really want one as a. It was never a thing that, as a girl, I want a doll house. It's something that I mean, I have kind of arrived at miniature making from a more at a much later stage in my life, more like an artistic endeavor. So my entire approach to dollhouses has been different. And yes, you're right, it is. I think it can there are ways in which you can approach the entire art of dollhouses in an incredibly gender inclusive way. In fact, in a way where gender isn't even really a question, because for me at least, when I was putting this project together, it was so hinged on the narrative and the character development that gender really wasn't as much of a question. It wasn't like I was building a dollhouse because I'm a girl. It was because I'm building a dollhouse because I want to tell a story, and I think that telling the story in miniature would be interesting, and therefore the dollhouse becomes a consequence of that rather than the point of it. If we start making it more about the stories that you can start telling with this medium, it automatically becomes more inclusive. Because I remember when we hosted the open house at Studio Slip. We had a lot of kids there at the event because a lot of our guests and clients, they brought their children, because we said, we're hosting a miniature making workshop, so you can bring your children as well. It's an all ages welcome workshop, and so a lot of them brought their kids, and there was really no division between the boys and the girls. It's not like the girls were more interested or more engaged. All of the boys were just as fascinated with seeing something at this scale and being able to kind of relate to the little stories that are hidden in various pockets of the house, and seeing that all the books in the bookshelf are donated by actual people, or all the artwork is donated by actual artists. And they were able to kind of immerse themselves in the universe of this little person, and it had nothing to do with it being a it stopped being just like a dollhouse to them. It was more like a story that they were becoming immersed in. And there was this little boy, I think he was about 5 years old, who was very interested in the life of little R, and he wanted to know more about her. And then he, in fact, during the mini making workshop, he painted like this little planter, which he was supposed to take back home with him, but he was very insistent that he gift the planter to little R as a housewarming gift. And that boy is only 5 years old. There's no he's not understand He's not necessarily processing this project at any complex abstract level. To him, for all you know, it's just a dollhouse. But at the same time, he's able to engage with it because I think they're engaging at the level of the narrative and the level of the character, rather than it being a dollhouse. So I think the even the idea of I think what we, in terms of making dollhouses more gender inclusive, I think that entire term kind of needs to dissolve. You know, this idea of it being a dollhouse, the idea of it being a doll itself kind of turns it into like this playful, frivolous, girly thing. But I think, you know, if we start making it more about what you can do with it as a tool for storytelling, I think that automatically starts to dissolve some of the gender stereotypes that surround that, you know, that particular phenomenon. So, yeah. If I were to look back at all of the interaction that I've had on social media, there hasn't been too much of a bias in terms of gender. Like, it's not like a majority of women are interacting with the project. People have been interacting in quite a in equal measure, whether it's, I mean, to the point where I'm not even thinking, oh, I have a greater number of female followers. That's not the case, because for me, everybody seems to be asking me questions. Some people are more interested in the miniature construction aspect of it. Some people are more interested in the storytelling aspect of it and want to know more about her life. But they're all finding these different ways to engage with it, men and women alike. And you know, they're when I run like an interactive Q&A session, or if I put out a question saying, oh, what coffee table books should she be putting on her coffee tables? And then people are interacting in equal measure. There are men who are, you know, sending, and from different age groups as well, you know. So I think an advantage with the miniature format is it's so, you can so instantly become immersed in it just because of the sheer scale of things. And, you know, you to be able to see something realistic happening at a much smaller scale is so instantly immersive that I think all issues and questions of gender sort of immediately go out the window, because you just really want to know more about what's happening in this particular space.